have a word for you. God has a word for you. When he approached me, and I was and I still am the kind of person who will curse you all the way out. Getting married is not going to solve any of your issues. I want to meet you. I want to go on It's Your Girl Minna. And in this video, we are going to be having a Get Unready With Me session in my bathroom, which is really one of my most peaceful places in the house. And I want to tell you a story about a time where a pastor hit on me, and there's no other reason that he hit on me than to sleep with me, okay? There could be no other reason. And I want to talk you through it and talk through some lessons that I learned from the whole entire ordeal, because in everything, you know, in everything, you shout all your glory. In everything, there's a lesson. And believe me, after it all went down, I was like, oh yeah, I need to do better. You understand? So we're gonna get them ready. I, you know, did my face earlier today. In case you're wondering, this foundation is the Huda Faux Filter Foundation. The color is Ganache. You have probably already seen the video by now. If not, make sure you watch that video here on YouTube. His hair, I'll link it below as well. The lashes, as always, in my description box. And the lip is Coco Tea from Jo Michelle Pro, and the inside is Back in Vogue from MAC. I know you're gonna ask those particular questions. Now that that is out of the way, let's get unready, taking all of this off. If you're like me, right, then at some point in your life, you've come to a place where you were like, God, like, when am I gonna get married? When am I gonna find a husband? Lord, send me a husband. When is it gonna be my turn? Matter of fact, let me take this wig off. I'm doing too much. I'm trying to be cute and it ain't working out. Mm-hmm. You used to pray like, God, when are you gonna send me a husband? I wanna be married, Jesus. Like, when, you know, when is my time gonna be? You either did that before you got married, or if you're not married, maybe you're still in that place where you're like, Lord, when is it gonna be my time, right? And that's just a natural thing for women, a natural occurrence in life, especially if you're in your 20s. Some people are really early and maybe feeling that way really early. I wasn't that person. I should let my head cap on, girl. I just remember being in my 20s and being like, Lord, you know, when is my time gonna be? This turban is from Amazon. I'll link it below as well. I'm leaving it behind because I am gonna wash my hairline in the shower. I started to really try to take control of the situation and try to take control over getting married, right? I've been married for 7 years now, but I tried to really take control of what was going on, right? How many of you have ever prayed for something from God and you, whether you knew it was him or not, you were just trying to like bullhorn it and just be like, okay, let's just see if this is what it's gonna be, right? In addition to prayer and just, let's just be frank, desperation, just from wanting to be married, I felt like that was what was going to complete me, but that's a whole nother story for a whole nother day. I started to feel like I was taking control of the situation. I was praying a lot about it and I was meeting all the wrong people, but I would think that they were the right people at first, and then later it turned out that they were not. You really shouldn't pull your lashes out, but here we are, okay? Life goes on. So it turned out later that they really weren't the right person, but I didn't know that until afterward. Again, I was really just like pushing the whole thing, okay? And later on, I got exhausted by that and I just fell back all the way back, and then God sent me my now husband. So there's that. So I just wanted to set you up in that sense to understand that I was essentially really, really like desperate for it, just wanting to be married, okay? And I know that, and I want you to comment below and let me know if you've ever been in that position before, because I know that I was not the only one at that time. I know that there are more women even now feeling the same way. I had gone to, and if, I'm gonna say an event, because I know that there are, if anyone who knows me in real life watches this, I want them to put things together, okay? I had gone to an event, and this is while this was many, many years ago, okay? Over 10 years ago, or close to 10 years ago. There was a pastor there, a Ghanaian pastor. I'm from Ghana, okay? I wouldn't say he was young, I was in my 20s. I don't know. He could have been in his 50s, right? Like, that's not young, but it's not old either. It's like, whatever. So he was like, you know, kind of charismatic in a sense. And he spoke to me at one point and I was just like, oh, you know, just in our culture, you know, you just like nice to all the adults. You really call them uncle, right? All the older adults are uncle and the older women are auntie. That's our culture. So, you know, he was nice and just speaking, whatever. Okay. And that just was what it was. There was nothing in that exchange. However, when he approached me, and I know, women, comment below, you know when someone likes you. Like, if you're in tune with yourself in life, you know when someone likes you, okay? And I was a single woman. I've had encounters, sadly enough, where older uncles or, you know, whomever, older uncles will make make inappropriate comments, make inappropriate gestures, that kind of a thing. And I was, and I still am, the kind of person who will curse you all the way out, because that is sexual harassment. It is inappropriate, and I don't tolerate that. He approached me, he didn't hit on me. It was just like, now when I look back, literally, it was like he was gazing into my eyes. And he was like, I forget the way he said it, but he was like, I have a word for you. God has a word for you. And I'm like, really? See, mind you, here I am, ears perked up like an animal, you know, dogs are like, whoa. I was like, really? He said something like, you know, something about a husband. And like, I can't remember if he said something like, I know God has shown me your husband, something like that. But the word husband is what stood out to me. And again, mind you, I was in that area of desperation, just wanting to bring my life full circle with the husband, which I know, and I've learned that getting married is not going to solve any of your issues. You're going to still have them issues. In fact, it's going to magnify them. But because I was so desperate to be married, I was just like, wait, what? He's like, give me a number and I'll call you. And I'm like, okay. See, I'm thinking of it just like, this is just a pastor who maybe he has some kind of prophecy, some kind of a vision he saw. And I've never seen him in a day of my life. Okay. And I'm thinking, oh, maybe he has something to say to me. This was what made me extremely vulnerable and extremely gullible. I gave him my number or something like that. And, you know, I came back home and he was communicating with me. And we were communicating via text or phone every now and then. But it was more and it wasn't for very long, because again, my whole intention was, where's the husband? Like, who is he? Where does he live? Like, what's the deal? Do you have an older son? Like, you know how people lie. You're like, yo, you have an older son, uncle, do you have an older, you know, do you have younger son, whatever, right? So I'm just like, okay, so what's the information? But he wanted to like prolong the conversation. He never really was getting to the nitty gritty of it. And at that time I had a dog, her name was Koi. And I remember he would communicate and be all like, oh, how's Koi, this and that. He had a daughter too. So like, just in communication, I'd be like, oh, how, you know, so-and-so. Honestly and truly, I was seeing it more like, this is an elder in my community. It's just more like a respect thing. Like, oh, you know, how so-and-so. But I really was more so like, okay, so where's this man at? Right. So I can't even take my makeup. I don't even know how I'm gonna take my makeup, my makeup off and talk about this. This is like, it's just, okay, let me at least get to that part. And then we'll talk some more, because I can't focus and do it at the same time. So let me take my makeup off with this Innisfree product, and then we're gonna continue the story. I find myself feeling distant. I don't like it. Am I tripping? Cause I'm a Christian. And now, as a leave-in conditioner, I'm trying for the first time this Olaplex Bond Smoother. And I know I still have makeup on my eyes. I'm gonna clean that in a second. This is all part of the process, girl. So, you know, we would just talk, I don't know, few times a week. I don't really remember. And I remember that I kept asking him like, so who's this guy? Where's the guy? Who's the guy? And he'd always be like, oh, don't worry, don't worry, don't worry. And I'd just be like, okay. So we'd be talking, he'd be asking me about me, I'd be asking him about him, and I forget what he did, but all I knew is that he had children. He never mentioned any wife. And I'm gonna tie this turban on. All the links to all the things that I'm using, wearing, are gonna be down below, FYI. Okay, so especially with this hair turban. So I'm just like, okay. Then he's like, okay, I'm gonna be in town on so-and-so date, and I want you to meet me. And I'm like, what? Meet you for what? Why am I meeting you? Are you gonna bring the guy? Like, what is happening right now? And he's all like, you know, I'm gonna meet you. I'm gonna use this to clean my eyes. This charade went on for a few weeks. It wasn't very long. I was really pressing him to figure out. I just needed to know where my husband was and when I was gonna meet him. And he kept stalling me. So he's like, I'm gonna be in town on so-and-so date. I wanna meet you. I wanna come over. And here I am like, come over and do what? Are you bringing the husband or what? And then I later realized like, what are you trying to do here? And I can't remember if I confronted him or what, but I, while the story was still in progress, I told a family member who was at the event about the situation, in hopes that maybe she was familiar with him. Because again, I had never seen him a day in my life. And I just was like, this is sounding real ridiculous. I think he's trying to hit on me. What is going on? Because remember, like I said, when he approached me, it was very like, I think he complimented me too. He said, you are very beautiful. God has shown me your husband. I need to get your number and call you, right? That specific chain of events hadn't ever happened to me. But let's keep in mind, I was vulnerable and I was desperate. Okay, so like I said, I talked to the family member and I'm like, yo, do you know who this is? Have you heard of this guy? I'm using my clindamycin lotion for my rosacea. Do you know who this guy is? Honey, child. First of all, I'm gonna use the Peace Out Retinol Eye Stick. She was like, he's married. I was like, excuse me? He's married with children. I said, Pardonnez-moi. And I'm just mortified. So I began to tell her what had been occurring over the past few weeks that we have been communicating. And she's like, oh my goodness, he was trying to hit on you. And I'm like, oh my God, he wanted to know where I lived, that he wanted to meet and all of this. And I'm just so mortified by the whole thing. And we were like, wow, he really tried it. He really, really tried it. And as egregious as his actions were, I really had to reflect and see how I fell into that, how I fell into what could have really gone awry. I don't know his temperament. I don't know his behavioral background. I don't know what he could have done to me, you know? It was just so scary to me to know that my desperation and vulnerability as a result of my desperation, it almost led me to a really tangled web, you know? I just was so mortified by that reality as I really thought everything through. This is first day of beauty nights in my dark spot serum. I just could not believe it. I was just like, here I am trusting that this man, this preacher, pastor, whatever the differences is, he was all those things. Here I am really thinking that he has a word from God, right? I wasn't saved at that time, so I didn't have any experience hearing from the Lord. I didn't have any experience in testing every spirit to see if it's true or not. I didn't have any experience or knowledge of just being careful. I was, again, vulnerable and desperate, just eager at my age to be a wife, right? How many of you are eager right now or have been in that place where you were eager? So I just clung to what he said and thought, oh, maybe he has a younger nephew or a son that he thinks would be a good fit for me. When I think back over that situation, I'm like, he really wanted to sleep with me. You weren't trying to find out my student loan balance to pay half of it. We all know what it is. And I had to think back to the way he looked at me when he approached me. It was very clear that he was referring to himself, but he's married. So what a scumbag, you know, what a snake. And it just really made me think like, yo, a lot of times we want to believe, and this is a whole different topic that I'm not gonna go on. We want to believe these pastors and preachers, and I know many of them do right by the Lord, but I know too many stories and I've experienced too much with this one story in particular to know that there are a lot of snakes in the grass. I share this story to say that we women who are eager to be married really, really have to be careful about our level of eagerness, right? When that level of eagerness and desire turns to desperation and obviously vulnerability, it's easy to be taken advantage of. Granted, I never met with him again, thank God, because I realized, like, I was very persistent. Where's the guy? Oh, don't worry. You know? So if you're someone that's like, oh, okay, well, let me just go meet with him and, you know, you never know. And then here he come, you know, sliding his arm or his hand under your dress and all these things, you know, what do you do? So I just really caution single women to really be careful about who you're trusting, especially if they are a man of God, you understand? And this is just really just a life lesson in general. But of course, when it comes to the body of Christ, because it's so easy to just want someone to prophesy over you or speak into your life about what have you, or hook you up with so-and-so, and you really don't know what their intentions are. Let's fell for it, because it's just important to give our desires to God, but then really leave it there and not ruminate over it so much that we then become an easy target for a snake, an easy target for someone that's looking to prey over us, P-R-E-Y, because obviously, so I don't know if he just sensed it from me or he was shooting his shot and it almost went in the hoop. You see, because I could have easily been like, okay, please. But he knew like, okay, she's fallen for it. And clearly he's done this before. First A Beauty Collagen Cream, I'll put it below as well. I think back to my single days and I'm just like, wow, Lord, like, again, I wasn't saved. I did not know Christ. I was raised in the church. I would go to church by force, not because I wanted to. I wasn't paying attention. I was just there practicing religion. And now that I know so much more, I'm just like, God, there's no way. I mean, I'm married now, but almost 10 years. But even if I wasn't, because I know so much more, there's no way I would have fallen for that. So I encourage you to really lean into the Lord more, lean into learning your faith and really understanding how to test every spirit and just be more mindful. mindful because, yo, the snakes are in the grass. And if he tried it with me, he's tried it before, and maybe he has been successful. I have no idea. I even forgot his name, but he definitely is a traveling preacher. If you're willing, I want you to share below if you've had any kind of encounter like that and how you, you know, how you dug yourself out. Hopefully you didn't fall for it, but if you did, just know that it doesn't make you a horrible person. You just were in a vulnerable and desperate place like I was. That is the video. This is my nighttime skincare routine. It's an abbreviated version of it. And hopefully this was a relaxing way to just learn a little bit more about me. Give the video a thumbs up. Make sure you're subscribed. And as always, I'm glad you're here. Thanks for watching. Bye. Sometimes I find myself feeling distant. I don't like it. Am I tripping? 'Cause I'm a Christian. Why do I feel like